Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. And in this tutorial, we're going to learn how you can install FerretDB using the Civo Marketplace. Let's get started. If you don't know what FerretDB is, it's an open source database, which is an alternative to MongoDB built on top of PostgreSQL. As an open source proxy, it seamlessly translates MongoDB wire protocol queries into SQL, utilizing PostgreSQL as its robust database engine. So if you are someone who is looking for an open source alternative to MongoDB, this video is for you. Now, before we get started with the tutorial, let's take a look at the prerequisites. So first of all, you need a Civo account. You can go to civo.com and sign up. You'll get $250 worth of free credits. You need a Kubernetes cluster, you need a MongoDB installed on your local machine, and you also need kubectl installed on your local machine. You can check out the links in the description below for documentation and resources. I'm going to install MongoDB on macOS, as it says. You can also install on Windows and Linux. Pretty simple, just using the brew command. I'm using Mac, so I'm just going to do brew install MongoDB. So here you can see it installing it, and you can install it on your local system. You can use it on whatever operating system you like. There are guides given on the website, in the documentation, for everything. Here you can see that I have my Civo cluster running. I can go to the marketplace in the UI, and I can go in databases, FerretDB. I can choose my plan. Let's go with 5 GB selected, and then I can just install the application. You can also install it via the CLI. To install it via the Civo CLI, you can use this command, Civo Kubernetes Applications, cluster, your cluster name, add FerretDB plan. Now in the plan, if you don't add 5 GB, 10 GB or 15 GB, it will automatically select 5 GB. And one more thing to note over here is that during the installation of FerretDB via the Civo Marketplace, a load balancer will be automatically created at an additional cost. So it is important to be aware that separate charges will apply for the load balancer service. So as you can see, we have FerretDB installed here. Now, if I want to access FerretDB, I'm going to use this command over here. MongoDB and the URL. Now the username and password, we can go to Kubernetes cluster installed applications in FerretDB. I can see my password and my username. So if I say click copy, my password will go over here. I can just copy my password, paste it over here. That's fine. And my username, I'll copy. And I have pasted my username over here. Right? So in order to get the DNS record of the load balancer, you know, that is associated with this cluster, as the command says, we can go to the Kubernetes cluster, and I can go to the manage in the networking, the load balancer section. Here you can see the load balancer over here, right? Pretty cool. Now, if you need the DNS name of the load balancer, you can go to your Kubernetes cluster, cluster information, scroll down, you will see load balancers here. Just copy this and that's it. I'm going to just paste it over here. That's it. That looks good. And you can see that it's connected. Pretty cool. Notice the format I used over here, MongoDB for the URL, then username, password, @host, then my port, and then my other arguments. Now, before we get started with the FerretDB operations, it's important that you know the basic terminologies. The first one being documents. Documents are self-describing records that contain the actual data and also the information describing that data. In terms of relational databases, you can compare it with rows in the tables. Unlike relational databases, documents in document-oriented databases have a fixed schema. The second terminology you have to know is collections. Collections in FerretDB serve as a repository for the documents and can be compared to a table in a relational database. When inserting documents in FerretDB, a new collection is automatically created if it does not already exist. Collections can hold one or more documents, allowing for the organization and storage of related data. Okay. Now, taking a look at some of the FerretDB operations, as we know that it supports MongoDB commands, so we can create use, let's say, MerchantDB. If it does not exist, it's going to create it for me, And to check if the you have selected the current database, you can write DB and it says merchant DB. So if a database doesn't exist, it will start for it for me and create it for me automatically. Now we'll look at some of the basic CRUD operations. Now the first one being the create operation. The create operation is used to add a new document in the collection. If the specified collection does not exist, it will create it automatically. This allows for dynamic creation of collections as documents are added automatically. Since I already have MerchantDB created, I'm going to write this command and you can see it says true. So basically I inserted the detail of a single merchant into the collection named merchant and I added some more information with it as well. You can also use the insert many function to insert multiple documents into the collection at once. Now I can use the read operation. So I can say db.merchant.find. So as you can see, it is giving me all the information regarding that. So here, as you can see, the read operation, it allows you to fetch documents based on specific criteria or filters. And you can do that as well. I can say find, and here I can basically add a filter. So I can say age is 22. There you go. So you can add in filters as well. Similarly, pretty easily, if you want to update, existing, let's say, document records within a collection, you can use the update operation and update one, email, set phone number, that acknowledge true. And when I try to find it, as you can see, it has added this phone number in it. Pretty cool stuff. Now, similarly, I can delete stuff as well. So if you want to delete multiple ones or you want to filter it accordingly, so I can say test at test.com, deleted count one. Now, if I try to search, it's saying it's empty because I just deleted it. That was it. CRUD operations, installation, everything pretty simple. Now, you may be wondering, Kunal, what are the benefits of using FerretDB? Well, first of all, it's open source under the Apache 2.0 license. So that's a plus one. It is also designed with transparency in mind. And if you are new to this, then it also prioritizes simplicity. So if you haven't worked with it before, it's pretty easy to use, as we just saw. Lastly, and one of the most important aspects is the community. So the open source community behind it, they're very passionate. And if you have any questions or any, you know, suggestions or just want to get started with it, are looking for resources, the community is pretty supportive. Well, that's it for this video. We learned the tutorial, how to install it using the Civo Marketplace, and we saw how to use it, basic CRUD operations, and you can check out the resources links in the description below. If you have any questions, you can leave those in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.